Farooq Dondi.
And why should an Indian MP care?
Farooq Dondi, it doesn't matter.
I think the question is.
Yeah, go ahead.
The question is much more fundamental. I think that even though we think we've adopted the British parliamentary democratic model, we actually haven't. What we've done is allowed, with the one person, one vote, and I don't see that there is an alternative to it, to elect absolutely a person who belongs to a particular caste or a particular region. We don't elect people on ideology. Britain has, through a long evolution, turned up parties that represent either the capitalist interest or, very broadly, the interests of other non-capitalist classes. And when that happens, you get MPs dedicated to one side or the other, who then can be called upon to research, to find out things, as you're saying. In India, we don't have that. We have somebody who represents one class of Dalits, or somebody who represents one class or caste of this, that, or the other. And it's all region, religion, caste, and so on. And so we don't have ideologically based parties, which is a problem.
So performance in parliament doesn't matter. Because it's more important for someone in the Congress to be close to Rahul Gandhi and Sonia Gandhi and keep them in good humor. The questions he asks and the quality of his debate doesn't matter, so nobody prepares.
No. I mean, I'm not one of those who would like to run down parliament and politicians. Don't do this, because if you do this, then you get self-styled civil society leaders who want to make law in the street. Okay, our parliamentary democracy may be skeletal, maybe it doesn't have muscle. You need to lend it muscle. And to say that all politicians are bad, that's also incorrect. You know, one of the things we do, I've done in my career is, you know, anybody who says this, I say, go and cover parliament for a month. You'll find that the breadth of vision of an ordinary MP is, you know, far larger than yours and mine, because of the nature of their job. You know, maybe 20% MPs give a bad name to entire parliament. To say that none of them work hard is also not correct.
No one's making that case.
Hold on a minute. To say that they should not jump into the well of the parliament is also wrong. You think you would have got JPC if people had participated in parliamentary procedure?
Repeated adjournments, lack of research.
Hold on a minute. No, not true. I'm saying you would not have got JPC if people had pretended everything was normal and participated.
No, but you can't depend on parliament not being, not working for a full month.
Don't go into how much does it cost to run parliament. How much does it cost to hold people accountable? How much does it cost to hold a government accountable which was doing nothing on 2G? JPC would not have been possible but for disruption. Disruption
Nalini
is a democratic technique.
Respond to what
I, you know, this is as much a cliche as what Akhila said about whatever I was saying, that it is a desultory house. I am saying, because we can achieve much better. We are capable. I can only agree that the Lok Sabha MPs, for instance, are very, very informed about their constituencies. I totally agree. But in terms of using the research, using libraries, using all the information which is available today, and putting it to good use in parliament and parliamentary debates, and not wasting time, as you say, why are we not able to say that without having another cliche jump on our crouch over here and jump on our neck saying, no, all over. Who is saying parliament is